Well, good morning, YouTube. So I've got my Breville Barista Express coffee maker opened up here. So anyway, I've removed the grinder, the top, I've got the back pop loose. This time, instead of removing these two screws down here that hold that valve and water tank connector in place, I'm going to try cutting the tie wrap on this hose here. So the other thinking is, if I can't get this one back on after I'm done, it'll be really easy to pull those two screws out, remove the valve, put the hose on, and then struggle with putting the valve back in. Getting this valve and connector back in place was probably the hardest part of doing the solenoid valve replacement.
Still a pretty tight fit, no matter what you do. Let's see if we can that without cutting the hose. There we go.
So that's what that looks like underneath there. And those screws are really hard to get to because you have to come in basically up into a blind hole because you can only see a little bit up inside there. So anyway, we've got that loose. So this is the new pump, and I picked up a new overpressure or safety valve. So we have to cut that tie wrap right here. There we go. Get that one out of the way. And then we have to get this one off. I guess it's the same kind of hose barb on this other one. I've also unplugged the wires from the solenoids here. The other one to take off is this plug right here. So this is for the flow sensor down here. We need to move this wire out of the way. And then there's a couple of wires down here. So there's the pump and the solenoids are wired the same. You've got neutral and then hot. There's neutral, hot. There we go. I'm not sure what this is. That's where that connector goes up in there. I don't see any electrical connections. It appears to be kind of glued in there. Okay, removed a whole bunch of whatever that was and get this thing out. Okay, well, yeah, I think this must be maybe some sort of a temperature fuse. So I'll see if I can look up anything on that part, and I'll put a caption here in the video if I can find anything about that. But kills the power to the machine if it gets too hot. Okay, and then there's two screws on the top. So the pump's mounted in this rubber bracket here, and then there's two screws on the bottom, and I think there's also a rubber bracket here, so that probably isolates the pump vibration. Okay, we got the top loose. Let's see if I can get the bottom. There we go. And let's see, move blue wires off to the side, green wires off to the other side. And then I think I might need to remove that tie wrap too, because there's no way to really get to the other end there. So I guess one extra tie wrap you gotta replace. Yeah, you just want to be careful you don't cut into the tubing there. So we got that one off right there. If I can get this one, try this thing here. I think it's stuck on the bottom there. You can kind of get in, and there we go. So I think we've got it there. There's the whole pump assembly. Yeah, so that Amazon pump is the same one there, EFP5 model. So yeah, I'll put a link to this pump and the safety valve assembly in the video description. Yeah, we've got to cut that tie wrap. No way to get that off underneath there. So yeah, this one's got to come off, then you can take the bracket off, put it on the new pump, and then put this back on. And then likewise, you've got to unscrew the top here. So you've got to take the safety valve off, and there's the clocking on it. So it kind of comes out sort of at a 45 degree angle from the pump. If you're going to reuse this one, you've got to put it on the new pump in the same orientation. And this just screws on. It's really tight. So there's the old valve. There's that ring. So let's see, we'll take that off. And then this is the top bracket. So you kind of wiggle the old pump out. Okay, I had to change video camera because my other one, I ran out of battery on the other one. So, you know, what we need to do is get that cut. Move it from the old one. We'll just get in here and snip that one off. So you're going to need 4 new tie wraps. Yeah, these kind of get stuck on there over the years. So the new pump didn't come with a new hose, so you got to be careful getting the old one off. There we go. And we've got the new pump, and we got to get this off here. Let's see, this was the top. Yeah, get that down. Oh, here we go. So you do need this piece off your old pump. That went down there. This is the new valve. You can see it's just threaded on there. Really fine thread, so you got to be careful you get it in there. You want to end up about like that, roughly 45 degree. Not quite ready because I got to take the bottom off of here. So then that one goes back on here like that. And then you can put the hose on the bottom. Okay, so I got the tie wrap on the bottom here after I put the bracket on. The one thing I learned from doing the solenoids is put the tie wrap on the hose before you insert anything. So I've got tie wrap on that hose, and then I've also got the one down here so that everything's ready to go because it's very cramped down there. This is just like it's a fabric adhesive. I figured just put a little bit there. I don't know why they glued it in so hard. Yeah, there we go. Get it started over that hose barb. I think the needle nose, because you got to hold the pump up while you get the hose slid on. So that works pretty good. So then you want to tighten that up. So we get that one out of the way. It'll probably be easiest to get the top screwed in there. At least that'll hold the thing up and out of the way. There we go. Get it loosely started. Figure I'll do this one because I can see it. And now if I can get this other screw. Yeah, I think that's a pretty good position for that. The reason you have to have that at an angle is to clear the solenoids. That's the problem with this, the way it's set up. Yeah, you can't turn that top thing. And this is just a thread up there. I guess that's tight enough. You have to just find the position. You don't want to go too tight because you'll strip those threads out. And if you go too loose, it's going to leak there. So I guess before we button everything up, I'll leave the thing open and just check for leaks on the first cycle. I can slide this over. I just want to be really careful with these. You know, you can't just yank on this because this is just plastic. Push down with a screwdriver, pull that tight, and then clean that one off. And then you have this one up on top. This goes into your thermocoil. Okay, yeah, we got it pushed in far enough, and then just make sure that goes all the way in. So we'll get this fuse or whatever it is back in there. It's got a little bit of adhesive to hold it in place. Okay, I found a regular pair of pliers, and I put them on the open position. And then you could grab this a little tighter. And there's just like a little lip on the inside of that split there. And there's just a little bump inside that you kind of have to push the thing up. And that forces it out. So I guess that's part of the retaining system there. I just couldn't grab it tight enough with the needle nose pliers. That seems to be the key there. Now we have to put everything back. So we had the yellow went on to the pump, and then the blue, I guess that's your neutral, like that. I got the pump wired up, and I've got my solenoids. So one thing I've done here is I've added some extra terminals on the solenoids because I'm going to be wiring up some indicator lights. So I put these indicator lights on the top of my machine. And I'm going to wire these into those same terminals. Here's your flow meter. And I put a red mark there. So the red wire goes over there. So we've got the pump in. I should probably tighten down those screws now. Yeah, I didn't
I left everything a little bit loose just in case I needed to take it out. So all four screws. We've got all the grounds. We've got that hooked up. That one. I've got this one hooked up. Everything there. So all we've got left to do is put the tank back on. Okay, now see if this thing will go back on there. I think if I can get up right about there and just get it started on there. Oh, almost. There we go. Hey, that's the way to do it. Yeah, that is much better. Get a second bite on there and shove it the rest of the way up to where the hose barb was and get it in the groove. Get it to stay in place. Yeah, there we go. It's just hard to get in there, but I think we're there. Yeah, that is definitely the way to go. Cut this tie wrap. Don't take those screws out. That was the wrong way to go. So let me button this back up a little bit. Well, I think I'll just put the top on loosely so that I can check for leaks inside. I just need to get this so it runs, and then we'll see what it looks like.